So when we think about medication and we think about response, we often delude ourselves, I think, into believing that there's a direct relationship between the medication and the response. So in the office, how well is the medication working? Do you feel like the medication is giving any side effects? Are there any aspects of the medication that you're not liking? As if there's a direct relationship between the medication and the clinical outcome. The reality is we all know from seeing these patients that there are a number of intervening factors. We know that medication response is driven by age. We know that medication response is driven by adherence. I don't know about you, most of my patients don't take their medication entirely as prescribed. But we also know that there's variation in these pharmacokinetic genes that I alluded to. And we're going to focus on those two, 2C19 and 2D6, because those are the ones where we really have the most evidence. Beyond that, we know that age influences metabolism. We know that medication dose is related to medication level. And we know that medication level for some medications can actually influence its own metabolism. We know that adherence affects medication level, and then we know that that exposure, concentration over time is what I mean when I'm saying exposure, is going to produce differences in terms of target engagement, again, where the rubber's meeting the road. We know that time is also important. And last, we know that there are a surfeit of clinical factors, which we all know as we're seeing that patient in the office. This is a patient who might not do well with this particular treatment versus that particular treatment, based on a comorbidity pattern, based on the target disorder, based on some other comorbidity or early life adversity, as you heard Dr. McIntyre talk about. And the coalescence of those factors is ultimately what drives our response. So what's the take-home message here? Number one, it is not just environment. Number two, it is not just comorbidity. Number three, it is not just adherence. Number four, it is not just pharmacogenetics.